All right. I've moved over to the steel range. I want to fire off the Stribog some steel there.
Not for
cutting,
but not for cutting.
With that's on, let's start with this crap. I'm pretty sure they're gonna fail, but let's give it a shot. Let's see how it goes. Right. Yeah, this bullet's no good. We'll try this one now. That's in. Charged. Safety off. This is with the ring. That's what this is. Okay, that was 20 rounds through the 20 round flawlessly. I had every red dot is zeroed perfectly, and we got 8 inch round targets out. Let's see, 5, 10. So we got 7 yards, 10 yards, 15 yards, 20 yards, 25 yards, all the way out. No issues with this one. Let's try the straight back. Okay, it's in. Drop the bolt on there. Let's pick some targets. And here we go. We have a failure. Let's clear the failure out. It's out. Oh, failure again. Hold on. Safety. Let me see if I can recover these. In, charge it in, build again. I think it is the ammo. The ammo's crap. Okay. Now, look. Okay, and I'm going to cycle these two bullets that didn't want to go through. It's too, that one. Let's see if they'll go through now. Okay, chambered in. Shot. Went through fine. Last one, curved. In. Charged. Let's see what we got. And we're done. Perfect. All right. Back to that if this has good ammo, it's gonna run every time. I had two failures there, two failures here, four failures. And out of four failures of steel ammo through all the magazines, through the Stribog. Okay, let me turn it off. It's off. Okay. Safety. Okay, drop the mag. Okay, so there it is. So here's the recap. Over on the paper target, I fired, say, 30 and 30 to 60, 70, 80, 90. 90 rounds on the paper, two failures. And they were attributed to this magazine, which has got a little chip in it on the feeder, on the feed lip. Then here, on the steel, I went with 90 more, and I had a failure on the 20, and then I tried to recycle it and try to put it through again, failure again on the same bullet, on the same old cartridge. So I think that was the cartridge. But they ran flawless through the magazine. These magazines have yet to have a failure on any ammo. But they're all steel ammo, and this is like shitty steel. This is the Winchester. I told you in the last video that I found it to be really shitty. But conclusion? If we have good ammo, brass case, quality ammo, I would say like a 124, 115, pretty much any grain, because I ran them all. This is 115 grain. The Bellum ran really well. But for home defense or for ultimate reliability, I would say 124. It could be hollow points through these mags. These mags do not fail. At least they haven't failed for me. These came close second. These did pretty good. This is crap. The other 10 didn't give me any problems, but I don't know. It's just a toy, okay? Now, let me tell you what I did. I think I mentioned this on the last video. So on the Stribog, okay, I have, I upgraded the trigger springs. So I did the trigger spring upgrade kit. Did that, I think it was an M-Carbo. I did the buffer, okay, upgraded that. So I got that on the internals. What else did I do? Oh, I mean, for the operation, those are the keys. I upgraded the bolt catch release, but for performance, I don't think that's matter. Put on this red dot. But what I did was, these are the latest generation magazines. I did spray dry lube throughout the magazines on the springs and the internals on all the magazines to mitigate the binding issue that supposedly they have. So that I did do. And you know what? I did that with all my magazines, on all my pistols. Okay. So that I recommend. This is clean. And so I'd say, bottom line, I'm really happy with this. In a home defense situation, I have my Stribog, I have my Mossberg Shockwave staged with all my favorite ammo ready to go. That gives me no trouble. I have that. I have my 45 double stack with defense ammo right there by my bed. I have no problem with that. And I have this. So I would probably reach for this first. Okay. I have that on with me. If I have to take defense mode, I'm going to have at least two pieces of firearms. And I can quickly scramble and get my shotgun. That just comes right off the wall, off the magnet. Okay. So, but I would actually go with this. And if I have any trouble, I'll drop it and just go with my sidearm. Okay. But, or, you know, and the other thing is I have multiple mags. So, you know, I'm gonna probably drop it. I'm in a real fight. I'm gonna go to my backup gun. And if I find myself tactically having to reload or, then I just go with the other mag. You know, I'm not a professional. That's what I would do. All right. Let me move to the other range. Okay. I'm at the other range where I'm gonna now fire off. I gotta practice my pistol. Okay, this is a custom one I built. But I'm going to run some of those there. I need to practice. So I'm going to pause so I can reload. You don't have to watch the reload on the magazines. And then I'll start.